So an integral part of Mangalorean cuisine, of the cuisine that's found here locally in Mangalore, a key part of that is the masalas. And in this day and age where everyone is busy, people don't perhaps have the time to prepare these masalas from scratch. And therefore today you have the trend of ready-made masalas. But when you talk about ready-made masalas, these are masalas that are prepared by individuals from their homes using recipes that have been in the family for a fairly long time. Those are the people that we're meeting today who are helping preserve in a way the flavors, the cuisines and the taste of Mangalorean cuisine. So I'm here with Gunakar and Sangeetha Furtado, and they have continued the legacy of making available these masalas that have been passed on for years now. So tell us, how did this whole concept of creating these ready-made masalas start?
Started with the restaurant which I was running, and it was going on good. And then I suddenly decided to change the cuisine.
Okay.
I have given up the kitchen to somebody else to run it, and they were doing the fast food. A lot of old customers, the regular customers used to come for 35 years, they have been running the restaurant. And they wanted the old food like that. So then we planned to bring out the masalas without any delay. They can just come from work, those who are working, especially the working families, and when they come back home, they can cook their food within 15 to 20 minutes.
So what we're going to do next is we're going to go to their home and take a look at how these masalas are prepared, and also hopefully do some cooking with those masalas, because at the end of the day, the proof of the pudding is in the eating. So stay tuned till the very end of this episode. So we're at the home of Gunakar and Sangeetha Furtado, and we're trying to find out what led them to create these special masalas that they now market in all of Mangalore.
It was the local masalas which we used to do earlier from the beginning. We started with just one item, roasting chicken. Then we went on to different items and went on adding these items, one all item right. after the other. So at that time when people demanded more food, then we had a clientele for that, and then we kept on increasing the items.
There's a whole range of masalas that you have here. So you've got, I can see, chicken pulimunchi, fish pulimunchi, fish curry masala, Kori Rotti, chicken curry. So are these masalas different, or are they the same with different?
No, they are different.
They are different.
Different ingredients for each masala. Now see, for fish curry we put coconut and all. For fish pulimunchi we don't put coconut.
Ah, okay.
And this Kori Rotti curry we don't put coconut. But we add coconut milk while making it.
Okay.
But a regular chicken curry masala, we add coconut and grind.
Ah.
So it varies like that. Somehow with coconut, somehow without coconut.
You know, when I smell this fish curry masala, the aromas take me directly back to a time in my childhood when my mom would, you know, grind the masala, and what I would smell would be the fenugreek seeds. And that's really what I smell in this fish curry masala. Sangeetha is going to help me use this fish curry masala to make a nice mackerel curry. I'm the one who's cooking it. And I'm hoping that this curry turns out to be something really special. So this is my first time making a fish curry. I was going to say making a Mangalorean fish curry, but this is my first time making a fish curry of any sort. So I've got a lot of hopes pinned on this. Now what's interesting is that this fish curry masala that we are using typically takes about an hour and a half to 2 hours to make the fish curry masala. But here we have the fish curry masala already ready in a box. And I'm told that this fish curry will take no more than 15 to 20 minutes. So now the onion has browned nicely, and Sangeetha has approved that we are ready to proceed to the next stage. And the next stage is basically the adding of the fish curry masala. There you have this beautiful masala that's going. I love the color. It's got a nice reddish orange sort of a color. I can already smell the aroma. You know, I can smell the coriander, I can smell the fenugreek seeds. This fish curry should be interesting. So we got some water just to empty out all the goodness of the masala. We don't want to waste any. So this pack that I've used is good enough for
four mackerel.
So that's roughly about
about a kilo of fish.
And now we're just adding some water. We've just added enough water for the desired consistency, right? You know, I can smell the aromas already. We need to also add the ginger and the green chili. So we're now just waiting for this masala, the gravy, the curry to start boiling away. Oh, it's boiling away. I think it's perfect. What do you think?
I would put a little.
Oh, you put a little more salt? Then we'll put a little more salt. Because then we'll also add the fish, right?
Yeah.
So when you add the fish, you know, the fish will also leave some water in. So perhaps you need to add some more salt in now to balance the fish out. So this is just some regular table salt that we've just added. The fish goes into the curry. Okay, so we'll just kind of give it a bit of a
shake
just to make sure that the masala is coating the fish well. You don't want to break the fish. You don't want to stir it, because if you stir it, you may break the fish. Is that the idea?
Yeah.
I'm sure your masala has done a good job, but I need to see if I've done a good job. You can smell the coriander. I think the fenugreek seeds. Beautiful aroma of all the spices. Super. Even though I say it myself after having cooked it, I think this is a brilliant fish curry. So cover it and just wait for some time, for a few minutes, for the fish to absorb all the flavors, all the goodness of the masala. So we've just finished cooking our mackerel fish curry using the rooster masala, and we're here at the table with Sangeetha and Gunakar Furtado. We're in here at Mangalore at their home, and the pleasant surprise that we have is that we've not just got the mackerel curry, but we also have a assortment of other dishes that they have cooked using the masala.
This is the prawn fry.
Which
we make the masala for that.
Okay. This looks delicious. I mean, look at the size of the prawns. I can already, you know, I'm just looking at it and my mouth is already watering, Sangeetha. This is of course the marwai.
Yeah.
You know, this is again a delicacy of Mangalore, marwai. That is clams in a sukka masala. So we have the chicken sukka there. Oh, lovely. Then we have the Kori Rotti masala. So we're going to first taste the fish curry, because that's what I made, and I'm going to get Sangeetha to taste it. Shall we? You know, if somebody fed this to me, and I would never know that the masala is a ready-made masala. This just tastes like somebody has made it at home. And I love the way the fish has soaked up the masala. Delicious. I think the fish curry masala,
so it was a success.
Definitely.
Kripal's cooking was a success.
No, not my cooking. I think what was a success was the masala that you have, the red rooster masala.
So the spices are okay?
You know, it's just balanced so beautifully to coat the fish. I think I'm going to go for the prawns. I'm already eyeing the prawns from here.
Mm.
along. You know, the flavor of the masala has gone all the way into the prawn. So I'm going to have the prawn now with the neer dosa. This is super tasty. The neer dosa and the prawn. Next, I'm going to try the marwai. You know, this is a dish that you have to work your way to the tiny marwai, which is packing in all the flavor. Oh, this is, you know, the coconut and the shellfish again have absorbed the flavor of the masala. You can taste the rich, you know, you can taste the masala has been roasted. So you get that toasty, roasted sort of flavor. This is good, thank you. So I've got the chicken sukka now on my plate. The roti. So this is a Mangalorean dish, which is the Kori Rotti. It's basically rice that is ground and then baked to form these crisp sheets. We break the roti. So soak the roti with the gravy of the Kori. You know, although you soak the roti completely, you still have that crunch of the roti. You know, I love the way the roti acts almost like a sponge despite its brittle texture to soak in all the flavors, all the goodness of the chicken curry. Delicious. You know, I thought I was going to come here and understand how these masalas are made. But all of this here has been a happy bonus for us. So thank you very much, Gunakar and Sangeetha, for hosting us in your lovely home and showcasing all these wonderful dishes made using your very special masala. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to share and leave a comment below. Do subscribe and stay tuned to Food Lovers TV for more episodes from Gourmet on the Road. Happy eating!